This is how some of our youth feel. Researchers show that over 100,000 Muslims leave Islam every single year. Our youth are full of doubts and nobody's answering their questions. And this is not only the problem. The majority of our youth are not even praying their 5 daily salah.
Apostasy is happening. In America, this is the last thing. 23% are becoming apostates of Muslims. American-born Muslims. Right.
Dr. Bilal Phillips, in a recent Friday sermon, openly has warned the Muslim community that apostasy will come like a tsunami.
And if we don't take constructive steps to deal with this, it is going to become an avalanche, a tsunami that is going to hit our community in such a way that we will have very difficult time standing. It will knock us over.
Wallahi, you would wish, if you're an Salafi, that they become an Ash'ari before they become a disbeliever. And you would wish, if you're an Ash'ari, they become and so on. Priorities. Most of the Ummah doesn't pray 5 times a day. Yani, come on, man. Like, seriously, do I have to even explain this to people, right? It's important that we prioritize. Then we can have the healthy discussions where people have reached a certain level. We can't afford it here, I'm afraid to say. Otherwise, you're going to see the community is going to change face. And our preservation is going to be at risk. Because you know what's going to happen? We're going to be eaten out from outside. We're talking about, you know what I'm trying to say? How to, it's not a leather sock. Yes, a leather sock. Who cares if it's a leather sock or not, man? Your child is going to become an apostate. And you're talking about if it's a leather sock. How dare you, man? It's a leather sock, you know. Shut up! No, shut up!
I mean, isn't it this is obvious? I mean, what kind of a prophet this prophet is?
Wait, so this verse is saying that he can postpone the turn of whom you will? What does that mean?
The women who is coming to have sex with him. You see, the Muslim in the translation, they lie, they say wives. There's none of them became a wife. Not even one of them became a wife. Those women, they want to sleep with him because he just told them in the previous verse, any one of them, they want to sleep with you, they are welcome.
You mean marry them, right?
Not what sleep. Marry them? Okay, name for me one of the women who gave herself to Muhammad became a wife. Go ahead. He did not marry any of them. Never. It's just for sex. Sexy club. The prophet sexy club.
Can you show me like the whole verse just so much so I can read?
I'm showing you the whole verse. Okay, here we go. You can read it, my friend. You can open your Quran from your side if you want. And then here it says, and any believing women, you know, we can change the translation if you want. I mean, this is my translation here.
This is verse 51 of which chapter?
Verse number 50 and 51 in chapter 33. Any woman want to give herself to the prophet, give herself to the prophet. Imagine we say to those people here, they are watching, hey, Christian Prince, Muhammad Hijab, he accept donation as cash and women, please. I mean, come on. Women? I mean, we arrived to the point we have no shame to say that any woman, she want to give herself to the prophet? How I can serve God by saying any woman, she can sleep with me? Unless you're Muslim, you believe that when Muhammad have sex, he have orgasm, and Allah, he have orgasm by Muhammad. Otherwise, what joy that will bring to Allah?
I don't know. This is...
Disgusting, isn't it? You have to agree, my friend. Come on. I advise you to leave Islam immediately.
Well, I don't know, because like... Well...
Come on, be honest with yourself. You see, you are a gentleman. You are a gentleman, and I'm sure you don't accept such a thing. I don't think your family, I don't think your history, I don't think your mother, your father are bad people. I think you are coming from a good family. So how in the world you accept such a man come to you and says, any woman she can give herself to me? What does this have to do with God? So I am here trying to help you, to show you that what you believe in is a scam. This man is not speaking for God. He's speaking for his panty. He's speaking for his private part. What the point of this? You see, giving charity, I understand why giving charity is very good. Helping others is very good. But you know, all good things to do for others are very good. But to do it for Muhammad, it's about sex. And you will see here, it says it's a privilege only for Muhammad. This is a privilege only for Muhammad. Why Muhammad, he needs such a privilege? What this purpose of this privilege? Is that going to make Islam better? Is that going to convince the Christians that Muhammad is a decent man?
Oh.
Actually, I can show you where your books, it's your books, your Islamic book says, that if the Prophet, his eyes fall into a woman, which means a woman, she was walking down the street, and Muhammad, he saw her. Her husband, he have to divorce her immediately so the Prophet can sleep with her.
Can I see that verse?
This is the official government website of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. And read with me here what it says. Amazing. Muhammad, he been given 16 privilege. The first one, Safiyul Maghnam, which means the best of the booty. So if we attack a house, the big screen TV go to the Prophet. The small TV goes for you. Al-Istibdadu bi-khums al-khums. Fifth of the booty will go to him. This is the second one. The three is al-wisal. The fourth is al-ziyada fi arba niswa, which means to have more than four women. Every Muslim can have only four. Al-khamis, al-nikahu bi-lafz al-hiba. Any woman she can give herself by just saying that. There's no need for witnesses, no need. He can just F her. Al-sadis, al-nikahu bi-la-wali. A woman, she can give herself to the Prophet without permission from her parents. Imagine, a Muslim, he cannot do that. A woman, she can do that to Muhammad only. Al-sabi' al-nikahu bi-ghayri sidaq. Muhammad, he do not need to pay dowry for the women. Al-thamin nikahu fil ihalat al-ihram. Even when he is doing ihram, he can have sex, but Muslims cannot. Al-tasi' suqut al-qasam bayn al-azwaj. He used to take an oath. Number nine, he can take an oath and he can break the oath. Only him. Muslims cannot do that when he take an oath for women. And al-ashir, إذا وقع بصره على امرأة وجب على زوجها طلاقها وحل له نكاحها. The mic is yours. Translate, please.
If he sees a woman, her husband has to divorce her, and she is permissible for
him to F her. Okay. What do you think of this? Why, if your Prophet saw a woman, her husband must divorce her immediately so the Prophet, he can sleep with her?
This is like,
imagine I am a person trying to say to you that I am here coming to serve God. I'm a servant of God. God, he sent me to you. And then I say to you, if I see your wife and I like her, you have to divorce her so I can sleep with her. What kind of religion this religion is?
Well, I mean, like, in the Bible, Solomon had 700 wives.
My friend, the Bible is a book of history and the book of God, which means history of people with God. So, in the Bible, it might say Christian prince, he commits sin. It might say Christian prince commit adultery. It might say that Christian prince, he killed people. It might say Christian prince, he have 1,000 women. But it's not God who told him to have and to do. There's a huge difference. Here, this guy, he claimed that this is coming from his God. We have in the Bible many people who commit sin, and they are asking God for forgiveness. As an example, David himself. He commits sin, and he asked God for forgiveness. He did not say that God told me to look at this woman and he sleep with her. He did not make an excuse that this is coming from God. What your Prophet doing, he want women to sleep with him, and he claim it is God. This is a privilege from God. This is not his fault.
I think you're right. This is like wrong.
So my friend, thank you very much. You see, you are a decent man. This guy, I told you, I have a feeling about people, you know. This person is coming from a good family. There's no way his owner will accept such a thing. If Muhammad tried to do that to your wife, I'm sure you will kill him because you have an honor. You are not a trashy person who will accept such a thing. You have dignity.
Yeah, this is wrong.
So denounce Islam, my friend. Say Islam is, obviously, Muhammad is a false prophet. Get out of this cult. They fool you. They say to him, he's a trustworthy. He is the good guy. He is the perfect man. He is the perfect between the best of mankind. They worship him. They made him in a point that nobody even dared to question his honor. But the second we start reading, and we did not even read much, there is tons of stories. Disgusting. We are just scratching the surface outside, and look what we found. And as long as you agree that this is wrong, that means Muhammad cannot be a prophet. Correct, my friend?
Yeah.
Thank you very much. I'm so happy for you that you decide to leave us now.
This is how some of our youth feel. Researchers show that over 100,000 Muslims leave Islam every single year.
But like, I don't know, like, if Islam is wrong, then like, what's the truth? Like,
my friend, I don't know, my friend, I've been raised. I advise you to go and download the Bible, the New Testament, because the New Testament is about Jesus and his teaching. The Old Testament is history and a lot of history. Read the teaching of Jesus and see what Jesus is about. Muhammad, obviously, he's a person working for his own. He opened a corporation. He put the title God, but the fact behind the title, there is something else. There's someone trying to use you and abuse you and take advantage of you. Read about Jesus. You will see it's the opposite. You are the one who said to me, the Christian believe that God died for them. So look how different is Jesus and Muhammad. Jesus, he came to us to save us, and even his life paid to save me. He did not ask me for a return. And look at this guy, he wanted to sleep with my wife. Jesus, he did not ask for money. Imagine if Jesus, he can raise people from death, how many kings they will give him everything they have. All the kings in the world, they will be his slaves. Just keep me alive, please. Each time I die, keep me alive. If Jesus want to abuse his power, which is beyond imagination, what Jesus can do? So I invite you right now, my friend, to accept the Messiah as your Savior. You breathe, but there is no guarantee that you will breathe tomorrow. Maybe you are young, but don't worry. There's many people, they are young and they die before the old one. I invite you right now as we speak to accept the Messiah, the amazing teaching of the Messiah, the Savior, Yeshua, the Messiah, Yeshua'ul Messiah, the only Savior, the one who says, love your enemy, for he have the authority. If somebody asks you for your code, give him your address. If somebody asks you to walk a step with him, walk with him 1,000. If somebody curse you, pray for him. Don't curse him and kill him. He did not say to people, give me your women. The second a man, he serves sex, it means he is serving the devil. He did not say, give me your money. God do not need money. And even servant of God, the second a man, he works to serve money, it means he is serving the devil. You see, all of us, we are sinners. And me and you, we are not better. We get tempted. We get tempted by women. We get tempted by sex, by money. But we don't claim that God is telling me to do that. That's disgusting. That is an insult to God, if God is a true exist. So I invite you right now, my friend, to accept the Messiah as your Savior. And you cannot say one day, I never heard of you, the Messiah. Because one day the time will come, and the Messiah will ask you, did the person, his name is a Christian prince, say to you, I invite you to accept me as your Savior, and you said no?
I like the message of Christianity, like love and forgiveness. I think that that's like nice. So, I don't know.
You know, my friend, you know, it's not only about forgiveness. It's not only about love. You see, the first thing Jesus teach you is not to be selfish. Jesus is anti-selfishness. Serve others so you can be served. When Jesus, he said to his followers, I want to wash your feet. They said to him, what are you talking about? You are our God. How you can wash our feet? They refuse. He said to them, if you don't let me do it, you don't belong to me. Imagine God himself, who is coming to us as a man, he is humbling himself and washing our feet. Why Jesus is doing that? He don't need to do that. This person is resurrecting people from death. This person is making the blind see. And then he said to them, I want to wash your feet. Because Jesus want to give us the best example how you can be a follower of him.
God is king, we the soldiers. Ultra beam out the solar. When I get to heaven's gates, I ain't gotta peek over. Keeping perfect composure. When I scream at the chauffeur, I ain't mean, I'm just focused. I ain't mean, I'm just focused. Put a lean out slower. Got us clean out of soda. Before the flood, people judge. They did the same thing to Noah. Everybody wanted Yandy. That Jesus Christ did the laundry. They say that we start on Monday, but the strong start on Sunday. Won't be in bondage to any man. John 8:33. We the descendants of Abraham. Yea, should be made free. John 8:36. To whom the Son set free. Say the rich like me.
Because Jesus want to give us the best example how you can be a follower of him. Because Jesus want to give us the best example how you can be a follower of him. So I truly from my heart, my friend, I invite you to accept the Messiah, because this is an opportunity. It might not come to you again.
I accept him.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. A happiness in the kingdom of God. A happiness in the kingdom of God for this brother who accepted the Messiah as his savior. The Bible says that happiness in the kingdom of God will be for one soul is saved. This is how much God he loves you, my friend. And now you are a child of God. Child of God, that means you are in his kingdom. You are under his care. You are under his protection. You are beloved for him. He is always about love. You made a decision. You will never regret. And the Lord, he loves you, my friend. I'm so happy today that you called me. I'm so happy that you reached the right decision.
Thank you. I'll have to keep this secret because, my family wouldn't like it. But I'll start reading the Bible and learn.
All right, my friend. If you have any question, feel free to call me. All right?
Okay.
All right, my friend. I'm so happy for you. I don't even know your name, but I don't care. For the Lord, he knows your name. Your name is not important. Your name might be Muhammad, but the Lord, he loves you. Your name is not what will define you from today. It is who you are. From their fruits, you will know them. And you will notice, my friend, that you will change. You will be a different person. You are not a black stone kisser no more. You will be a different person. You are not a black stone kisser no more. You are not in need to pray in direction of a stone. God is everywhere. And God, he don't care for people who pray in the corner. Actually, Jesus, he warned us not to be like them, not to be hypocrite. He said, when you pray, go to your closet. So I advise you today, before you sleep, my friend, anytime you wish, don't force yourself on a certain time to pray. This is Christianity, this is not Islam. God is not a bus station. He will take your prayer in a certain time. If you miss it, he will not take it. That is a joke. Anytime you feel like your heart want to speak to the Lord, speak to him. Say whatever you wish. He is listening. Be decent with yourself. Confess your sin. Say, God, I am a sinner. Speak about your sin. Not because you are proud of it, but because you are humble and you know that you are wrong.
I accept him.
Hallelujah.